agree or you disagree. Dalimbov uthi, people must forget and people must know this. And that is, Ramaphosa feels comfortable working with people. The country has been sold. It's a fact. How do, if you want to defend Ramaphosa against this, how do you defend Ramaphosa and say, oh, no, Ramaphosa, he did not do it. How do you do it? Like, tell me. I'm interested to know. How do you defend the decisions that Ramaphosa is making? Well, you know, speaking about the decisions that Ramaphosa is making, even ANC, NEC, I showed you a video. I did a video. They are fighting. There's a serious fight there. People said, no, we don't want DA. But Ramaphosa seems to want to go ahead because according to him, DA is a progressive party and MK and what is a regressive party. Do you know what it means? Reverse psychology. Unkulunkulu uthumele uJona eNinive, uSathane wamshanga reverse psychology wathi ungayi eNinive. The opposite of what God said he should be doing. That's reverse psychology. People in South Africa, 80% of people in South Africa said they prefer a coalition between ANC, MK, EFF, and other political parties, but not DA. Ramaphosa and his allies said DA. What is it that we don't know about DA that they know? What is this fixation about DA that we don't know? That is where the importance here, that is where the, that is what I basically say, how best can I describe this? That is where the concern should come from to say, what is this fixation about DA that we seem not to be paying attention? Why is Ramaphosa so fixated upon the idea of DA? This is an argument brought by Advocate Dalimbov. He's like, forget, it's done. They have sealed the deal, it's gone. And then he described some of those things to say, look at the attitude, look at the things, look at the positions that they are occupying. It is very strategic positions. And I got scared as he mentioned some of the things. Now, don't worry, I'll let you listen to Dalimbov. Don't worry, I'll give you time to listen to Dalimbov for yourself. But here's the thing. The thing is, how do you defend Ramaphosa against Dalimbov if you want to? But before you defend him, this is what you need to do. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge. And that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying? We'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
All right. So now I am gonna play you the video got Dalimbov, right? The reason I'm saying that is because Mina, you know my stand. My stand is very clear that I don't believe in Ramaphosa. I honestly don't believe in Ramaphosa simply because the man has been into power for many a times. He has failed to do something significant. Right now, I can tell you this, history, look, you will remember this. Ramaphosa, even this year, is going to be the most, look, even this second term, Ramaphosa will be the most unproductive president ever in the ANC, in the history of the ANC, in the history of black presidents in South Africa. Ramaphosa will be, because right now, what is going to happen is that he's going to hide with this GNU. He's going to, but Ramaphosa's intention is not to develop this country. He had a fair opportunity to do that. He failed dismally. He's just looking for people to hide with. He's just looking for people who are going to, whom he's going to use as a scapegoat. But the reality is that Ramaphosa, guys, has failed. But before we proceed with this video, take a look at the Talimpo side here.
So you must accept, South Africans must accept emotionally that we're back in apartheid, that our country has been bought back with 30 pieces of silver paid to Cyril Ramaphosa, and that he has betrayed the revolution. So the deal is going to happen. Mm-hmm. Now, how the deal is going to happen is that the DA will get some of what it wants. So in other words, they'll do maybe an addendum of some sort to the agreement, mm-hmm. and try to relax some of the clauses so that the deal can go through, or delay and say that they'll deal with difficult issues afterwards and so on. So some kind of delaying tactic, mm-hmm. that allows the president to appoint a cabinet. Then thereafter, the DA is going to then want their pound of flesh. That's why they say if they have a department, they want the minister, the deputy minister, and the DG. The so-called cadre deployment that they've been running around, now they want to do it, that they've been opposing in courts, now they want to implement it. Because they want to have a complete control, so that even the tenders must go to their preferred people. When tenders go to white people, it's not going to be called corruption. It will be called good mm-hmm. governance. Yeah. And so they want to consolidate their power while Ramaphosa is still in place, because they know that thereafter the real revolution is going to take place, and mm-hmm. the Christmas is going to be over. So it's like the last feeding frenzy of the corrupt ANC and the corrupt DA forces, to make sure that they enjoy however long this thing is going to last, a year, 6 months.
You know, I'm looking at the look at this thing issue. You're looking at the departments that they wanted to control. The DA was very strategic in which department they want to control and why they want to control those departments, right? And what would have happened had they gotten a full control power of everything? What will happen, right? It's only a matter of time. It's just a matter of time before we see some incredible things that, in fact, horrible things that they are going to do. Because these people have been clear on the matter. When South Africa says, we're talking about the thing that is happening in Israel, look, this political party, they've been saying that, no, actually, no, whatever is happening, like they promote Israel, right? So we've had people like that here. Now you want to work with them. Like, DA guys, right now, you must look at what they are doing in Gauteng. They want to control everything. They want to tell look, they want to tell Panyaza Lesufu, good, listen. When in your NNC, you must know that here, we want to work with this and this. Guys, can you imagine me being invited in your house, and then I start telling you what to cook and what not to cook in your house? That's DA for you. In your house, I then tell you what to eat and what not to eat and how to cook and how not to cook. That's DA for you. Then Ramaphosa has got such an audacity to invite people who believes that colonialism was never a bad thing. How do you even start a conversation with such a person who was forced to apologize? People who, most of them are accused of racism, how do you even start a conversation with them, knowing exactly that these people are not for you, they are for themselves? And they've demonstrated time and again that we're not for you. We are. So if you think that, I don't believe that Ramaphosa will do anything significant this year. I can tell you this in this second term. Right now, this is a perfect strategy for Ramaphosa to hide. We will be lucky if load shedding doesn't return. People must pray. The reason I'm saying we'll be lucky is because, despite the fact that right now,
800 megawatt has been added into Eskom, meaning people shouldn't have load shedding because there's been added power. But even then, because it benefits the people he's working with, the funders of the people he's working with and his funders, if load shedding makes them money, this year definitely load shedding is coming back. It's just a matter of time. So even then, because this year there is GNU, he's going to blame it on the GNU that is unable to make decisions on time, as if when he was able to make decisions on time, he was effective. That is what is going to happen, because Ramaphosa doesn't mind to lie blatantly. You know, politicians guys lie, but not Ramaphosa will fool you broad daylight. Bonke babuk. Ramaphosa will just tell you a lie and then a pumagu.